काका कुपामा सुत्ता द सिमिली अफ द स वन्स मङ्क्स इन दिस सेम साबत्थी देयर वाज अ लेडी अफ अ हाउस होल्ड नेम्ड विदेहिका दिस गुड रिपोर्ट अबाउट लेडी विदेहिका हेड सर्कुलेटेड लेडी विदेहिका इज जेन्टल लेडी विदेहिका इज इवन टेम्पर्ड लेडी विदेहिका इज काम नाउ लेडी विदेहिका हेड अ स्लेव नेम्ड काली हु वाज डिलिजेन्ट डेफ्ट एन्ड नीट इन हर वर्क द थट अकर्ड टु काली द स्लेव दिस गुड रिपोर्ट अबाउट माई लेडी विदेहिका हेज सर्कुलेटेड लेडी विदेहिका इज इवन टेम्पर्ड लेडी विदेहिका इज जेन्टल लेडी विदेहिका इज काम नाउ इज एङ्गर प्रेजेन्ट इन माई लेडी विदाउट सोइङ अर इज इट एब्सेन्ट अर इज इट जस्ट बिकज माई वर्क इज निड द्याट द एङ्गर प्रेजेन्ट इन माई लेडी डज नट सो वाइ डन्ट आई टेस्ट हर सो काली द स्लेभ गट अप आफ्टर डे ब्रेक देन लेडी विदेहिका सेड टु हर हे काली यस म्याडम Why did you get up after daybreak? No reason, madam. No reason, you wicked slave. And yet you get up after daybreak. Angered and displeased, she scowled. Then the thought occurred to Kali the slave. Anger is present in my lady without showing and not absent. And it's just because my work is neat that the anger present in my lady does not show. Why don't I test her some more? So Kali the slave got up later in the day. Then Lady Videhika said to her, Hey Kali, yes madam, why did you get up later in the day? No reason madam, no reason, you wicked slave, and yet you get up later in the day. Angered and displeased, she grumbled. Then the thought occurred to Kali the slave, anger is present in my lady without showing and not absent. And it's just because my work is neat that the anger present in my lady does not show. Why don't I test her some more? So Kali the slave got up even later in the day. Then Lady Videhika said to her, Hey Kali, yes madam, why did you get up even later in the day? No reason madam. No reason, you weak slave, and yet you get up even later in the day. Angered and displeased, she grabbed hold of a rolling pin and gave her a whack over the head, cutting it open. Then Kali the slave, with blood streaming from her cut open head, went and denounced her mistress to the neighbors. See, ladies, the gentle one's handiwork. See the even-tempered one's handiwork. See the calm one's handiwork. How could she, angered and displeased with her only slave, for getting up after daybreak, grab hold of a rolling pin and give her a whack over the head, cutting it open? After that, this evil report about Lady Videhika circulated. Lady Videhika is vicious. Lady Videhika is foul-tempered. Lady Videhika is violent. In the same way, monks, A monk may be ever so gentle, ever so even-tempered, ever so calm, as long as he is not touched by disagreeable aspects of speech. But it's when disagreeable aspects of speech touch him that he can be known from experience as gentle, even-tempered and calm. I don't call a monk easy to admonish if he is easy to admonish and makes himself easy to admonish only by reason of robes, arms food, lodging, and medicinal requisites for curing the sick. Why is that? Because if he does not get robes, arms food, lodging, and medicinal requisites for curing the sick, then he is not easy to admonish and does not make himself easy to admonish. But if a monk is easy to admonish and makes himself easy to admonish purely out of esteem for the Dhamma, respect for the Dhamma, reverence for the Dhamma, then I call him easy to admonish. Thus, monks, thinking we will be easy to admonish and make ourselves easy to admonish purely out of esteem for the Dhamma, respect for the Dhamma, reverence for the Dhamma, That's how you should train yourselves. Monks, there are these five aspects of speech by which others may address you. Timely or untimely, true or false, affectionate or harsh, beneficial or unbeneficial, with a mind of goodwill or with inner hate. Others may address you in a timely way or an untimely way. They may address you with what is true or what is false. They may address you in an affectionate way or a harsh way. They may address you in a beneficial way or an unbeneficial way. They may address you with a mind of goodwill or with inner hate. In any event, you should train yourselves. Our minds will be unaffected and we will say no evil words. We will remain sympathetic to that person's welfare with a mind of goodwill and with no inner hate. We will keep pervading him with an awareness imbued with goodwill, and beginning with him, we will keep pervading the all-encompassing world with an awareness imbued with goodwill. Abundant, expansive, immeasurable, free from hostility, free from ill will. That's how you should train yourselves. Suppose that a man were to come along carrying a hoe and a basket, saying, I will make this great earth be without earth. He would dig here and there, scatter soil here and there, spit here and there, urinate here and there, saying, be without earth, be without earth. Now what do you think? Would he make this great earth be without earth? No, Lord. Why is that? Because this great earth is deep and enormous. It can't easily be made to be without earth. The man who would reap only a share of weariness and disappointment. In the same way, monks, there are these five aspects of speech by which others may address you. Timely or untimely, true or false, affectionate or harsh, beneficial or unbeneficial, with a mind of goodwill or with inner hate, others may address you in a timely way or an untimely way. They may address you with what is true or what is false. They may address you in an affectionate way or a harsh way. They may address you in a beneficial way or an unbeneficial way. They may address you with a mind of goodwill or with inner hate. In any event, you should train yourselves. Our minds will be unaffected and we will say no evil words. We will remain sympathetic to that person's welfare with a mind of goodwill and with no inner hate. We will keep pervading him with an awareness imbued with goodwill, and beginning with him, we will keep pervading the all-encompassing world with an awareness imbued with goodwill equal to the great earth. Abundant, expansive, immeasurable, free from hostility, free from ill will. That's how you should train yourselves. Suppose that a man were to come along a carrying lac, yellow or pigment, indigo or crimson, saying, I will draw pictures in space. I will make pictures appear. Now, what do you think? Would he draw pictures in space and make pictures appear? No, Lord. Why is that? Because space is formless and featureless. It's not easy to draw pictures there and to make them appear. The man would reap only a share of weariness and disappointment. In the same way, monks, there are these five aspects of speech by which others may address you. Timely or untimely, true or false, affectionate or harsh, beneficial or unbeneficial, with a mind of goodwill or with inner hate. Others may address you in a timely way or an untimely way. They may address you with what is true or what is false. They may address you in an affectionate way or a harsh way. They may address you in a beneficial way or an unbeneficial way. They may address you with a mind of goodwill or with inner hate. In any event, you should train yourselves. Our minds will be unaffected and we will say no evil words. We will remain sympathetic to that person's welfare with a mind of goodwill and with no inner hate. We will keep pervading him with an awareness imbued with goodwill, and beginning with him, will keep pervading the all-encompassing world with an awareness imbued with goodwill equal to space, abundant, expansive, immeasurable, free from hostility, free from ill will. That's how you should train yourselves. Suppose that a man were to come along carrying a burning grass torch and saying, with this burning grass torch, I will heat up the river Ganges and make it boil. Now, what do you think? Would he, with that burning grass torch, heat up the river Ganges and make it boil? No, Lord. Why is that? Because the river Ganges is deep and enormous, it's not easy to heat it up and make it boil with a burning grass torch. The man would reap only a share of weariness and disappointment. In the same way, monks, there are these five aspects of speech by which others may address you, timely or untimely, true or false, affectionate or harsh, beneficial or unbeneficial, with a mind of goodwill or with inner hate. Others may address you in a timely way or an untimely way. They may address you with what is true or what is false. They may address you in an affectionate way or a harsh way. They may address you in a beneficial way or an unbeneficial way. They may address you with a mind of goodwill or with inner hate. In any event, you should train yourselves. Our minds will be unaffected and we will say no evil words. We will remain sympathetic to that person's welfare with a mind of goodwill and with no inner hate. We will keep pervading him with an awareness imbued with goodwill, and beginning with him, we will keep pervading the all-encompassing world with an awareness imbued with goodwill, equal to the river Ganges, abundant, expansive, immeasurable, free from hostility, free from ill will. That's how you should train yourselves. Suppose there were a cat skin bag, beaten, well beaten, beaten through and through, soft, silky, free of rustling and crackling, and a man were to come along carrying a stick or shad and saying, with this stick or shad, I will take this cat skin bag, beaten, well beaten, beaten through and through, soft, silky, free of rustling and crackling, and I will make it rustle and crackle. Now, what do you think? Would he, with that stick or shad, take that cat skin bag, beaten, well beaten, beaten through and through, soft, silky, free of rustling and crackling, and make it rustle and crackle? No, Lord. Why is that? Because the cat skin bag is beaten, well beaten, beaten through and through, soft, silky, free of rustling and crackling. It is not easy to make it rustle and crackle with a stick or shard. The man would reap only a share of weariness and disappointment. In the same way, monks, there are these five aspects of speech by which others may address you, timely or untimely, true or false, affectionate or harsh, beneficial or unbeneficial, with a mind of goodwill or with inner hate. Others may address you in a timely way or an untimely way. They may address you with what is true or what is false. They may address you in an affectionate way or a harsh way. They may address you in a beneficial way or an unbeneficial way. They may address you with a mind of goodwill or with inner hate. In any event, you should train yourselves. Our minds will be unaffected and we will say no evil words. We will remain sympathetic to that person's welfare with a mind of goodwill and with no inner hate. We will keep pervading him with an awareness imbued with goodwill, and beginning with him, we will keep pervading the all-encompassing world with an awareness imbued with goodwill equal to a cat skin bag, abundant, expansive, immeasurable, free from hostility, free from ill will. That's how you should train yourselves. Monks, even if bandits were to carve you up savagely, limb by limb, with a two-handled saw, he among you who let his heart get angered, even at that, would not be doing my bidding. Even then, you should train yourselves. our minds will be unaffected, and we will say no evil words. We will remain sympathetic, with a mind of goodwill, and with no inner hate. We will keep pervading these people with an awareness imbued with goodwill, and beginning with them, we will keep pervading the all-encompassing world with an awareness imbued with goodwill. Abundant, expansive, immeasurable, free from hostility, free from ill will. That's how you should train yourselves. Monks, if you attend constantly to this admonition on the simile of the sa, do you see any aspects of speech, slight or gross, that you could not endure? No, Lord. Then attend constantly to this admonition on the simile of the sa, that will be for your long-term welfare and happiness. That is what the Blessed One said, gratified, the monks delighted in the Blessed One's words.